I think mathematicians have a big job to do, to talk to people about what we love about doing mathematics. And what we love is our job is very creative. We're problem solvers, we're questioners, we're thinkers, and we're trying to understand the world.
SIAM Connect, it's a website, connect.siam.org, where they post lots of interesting stories about math things that are going on in the world. The intended audience is a more general audience. I mean, it's also for SIAM members to see what's going on sort of across the broad spectrum of mathematical activities happening at SIAM, but also for the general public to say, hey, that math is accessible and you don't have to be a PhD or a trained scientist to understand the interesting things happening in math.
For students, I think a very valuable section is the SIAM Nuggets, since they get a digestible summary of articles published in SIAM journals. Because particularly for undergraduates, when they think careers in math, they're steered towards just teaching. They think the only thing they can do with a math degree is teach. And this lets them know that there's something else out there for them, and that applications that they might find interesting, there's a strong mathematical component. So if they are really good at math, there's a career for them in it.
SIAM Presents is a collection of about 1,500 talks, invited talks, plenary talks, and mini tutorials from our meetings. They're really the full-length talks, but we take little vignettes out of them that provide a bit of a potpourri of what's going on in applied mathematics, and some of them are actually cool to watch, so people can get a feeling of what applied mathematics is, why it matters to society at large, and some of the interesting problems, exciting problems that we're working on.
For students, I think we often see an interest in mathematics, but they don't understand that they can be a mathematician. And so SIAM helps facilitate that message by providing information about ways mathematics is used in the real world. And so we use Math Matters as an example to show them different ways math is used in industry to solve problems and also in areas they may not expect. For example, animation and digital arts.
Why do math started with the idea of when you teach calculus specifically, you always have students coming up and saying, well, why am I doing this? So we thought it would be good to, at that level, try to explain the many successes that the mathematical sciences have had in solving issues that are outside of mathematics per se. My favorite is the interplanetary superhighway. It's not well known that for the space missions, in order to go from A to B in the most fuel-efficient way, you sometimes go millions of miles, literally, out of your way. And how this works is a little bit of dynamical systems, and it's understandable with pictures. And the web is also layered, so that the deeper you go, the more you learn about the mathematics that's involved.
The SIAM Education Committee has, along with the American Statistical Association and the NSF, been looking at mathematical modeling in the K-12 and even through 16 educational system. Mathematical modeling is the way applied mathematicians describe the world using mathematics. And mathematical modeling is really coming into school curriculums more than ever. So applied mathematicians have a great role to play in both talking about how that's important in our jobs and then supporting teachers as they work with their students on these kinds of problems.
The Moody's Mega Math Challenge is a competition for high school juniors and seniors where they work on an open-ended problem for a day and use modeling to propose a solution. They're problems that the students can connect with and actually make progress with in a short period of time. And we've developed a modeling workbook that goes with it to guide teachers in the modeling process and help promote, in a sense, some best practices when it comes to tackling those problems.
I think the best way that we can help is sort of by helping SIAM and write blogs and to connect on Twitter and to help SIAM to have kind of a, you know, an army of people to go out there and help raise public awareness.